Hi everyone, welcome to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews. If you are an Amazfit fan, this video is for you. Today we're doing the ultimate Amazfit Heart Rate Accuracy Challenge. In today's test, we have the Amazfit Band 5, Bip U, GTS and GTS2 Mini. Baseline will be the heart rate measured by Polar H10 Chest Strap. We'll go through the plots and charts of each, and at the end of the video, we'll rank the four trackers based on the factual metrics recorded. If you are new to WesKnows Tech News and Reviews, we talk about the latest tech news. We do brutally honest reviews and share hacks and tricks along the way. Yesterday, I took the four trackers out on an evening run. As you can see from the tracing in the Polar B-Tap, I ran 7.4 kilometers in just 1 hour. The average heart rate was measured at 158 beats per minute, and the max was 183 beats per minute. The trackers were strapped up tightly on my wrists. I started the run on all four devices simultaneously and took off. I have overlaid the heart rate plots of every smartwatch over the Polar H10 HRM chart. Let's go through each one with a short recap of what the tracker offers and then its test results. By the end of the video, we'll rank the results to find the most accurate optical heart rate sensor of the tested watches. Feel free to skip through to the section you want with the timestamps I've left in the description. First up is the Amazfit Band 5. This is the traditional fitness tracker, costing just 30 bucks. Essentially, it's a newer and improved Xiaomi Mi Band 5. It has a slightly wider case, still plasticky, same TPU strap from which you can pop out the tracker face. There's a 1.1-inch AMOLED display. It's waterproof up to 50 meters. There are 11 sport modes, and you also get two auto-recognized activities, walking and running. You get an array of apps and monitors that track your PI, blood oxygen saturation, stress level. There's a timed breathing app. And the cherry on top is that it does get Alexa to tell you a joke, share directions, or tell you the weather forecast. And we can see that the watch measured an average heart rate of 157 beats per minute and a max of 177. The average heart rate variance is under 1% at just 0.6%, while the max is off by 3.3%. From the charts, we can see why the max is significantly lower than the chest strap. The only spike was literally cut off. In regards to the rest of the chart, it's scary how such a cheap tracker manages such accurate readings over a 1 hour run or 3,600 data points, one every second. Now let's take a look at Amazfit Bip U. So this one costs about 50 bucks. The design brings us closer to a smartwatch rather than the traditional tracker. The display is a 1.43-inch color TFT LCD display. There is a 20mm replaceable silicon strap, there are 60 sport modes to choose from, and all exercises are now goal-based. There's no inbuilt GPS here, just connect a GPS via Bluetooth connection with your phone. The band is water-resistant though, so you can take it swimming. You get an array of apps and monitors that track your PI metric, blood oxygen saturation, stress level, there's a timed breathing app, and the cherry on top is the female cycle tracker. There are also some advanced apps that were brought in from the more premium smartwatches, such as the Pomodoro tracker and the World Clock. The watch did run out of battery 42 minutes into the run, so we only have about two-thirds of the plot here. During that period, the Bip U measured an average heart rate of 155 beats per minute and a max of 183. So the average heart rate variance is 1.9%, while the max is spot on. The tracing of the heart rate peaks is very accurate, but the troughs are slightly overestimated, and hence the heart rate average is pulled lower than the Polar ECG strap. Now let's take a look at the Amazfit GTS, and it costs approximately 120 bucks, but you can get it on special or on discount for as low as 100. Basically, you get a 1.65-inch AMOLED display with a resolution of 341 ppi. You also get 20mm replaceable straps. There are 12 preset sport modes that are goal-based. Additionally, it has inbuilt dual GPS, and the GTS can actually push out 25 hours of GPS-recorded activities from a single charge. There are also an air pressure sensor, a compass, and an altimeter. And of course, you also get the PI metric. The watch measured an average heart rate of 156 beats per minute and a max of 182. The average heart rate variance is 1.3%, while the max is off by just 0.5%. From the charts, we can see only one distinct reading that is not in line with the ECG chest strap. The peaks and troughs are pretty much in sync with the chest strap for the full 1 hour. And lastly, we have the GTS2 Mini, which costs just under $100 or £80 in the UK. It's almost square with dimensions of 40.5 by 35.8mm. It's very slim and sits just 9mm on top of your wrist. It has an aluminium alloy frame around the bezel, highlighting the premium as opposed to the Bip U. The AMOLED display is 1.55 inches and has a 301 ppi resolution. You get 70 goal-based sport profiles, smart alerts and inbuilt GPS. You also get a vast amount of apps and monitors that track your PI, blood oxygen saturation, stress level. There's a timed breathing app, there's a female cycle tracker, there's a Pomodoro tracker and world clock apps too. The cherry on top is that in the near future, Alexa is coming via an OTA update. The watch measures an average heart rate of 154 beats per minute and a max of 184. The average heart rate variance is 2.5%, while the max is just over by 0.5%. The tracing in general is good, recording of the peaks and the troughs, but we see a number of points on the plot where the troughs are recorded lower than by the chest strap, and that is the reason for the lower average result. Let's discuss the results, rank them, and potentially make some conclusions. If you have watched our prior tests with other tracker manufacturers, you will appreciate that the Amazfit heart rate sensors are up there with the best in class. Even with these four watches, the optical heart rate sensors on the budget trackers and budget smartwatches are tracing your heart rate almost in sync with the professional grade ECG chest strap from Polar. Personally, I'm very impressed. Considering the Bip U only lasted 2/3 of the full run, we'll have to default it to 4th place. 3rd place goes to Amazfit Band 5. The average heart rate is just 0.6% out of sync, but the 183 beats per minute spike was not registered and gave us a 3.3% variance. The runner-up is GTS2 Mini. It does a solid job of following the peaks and the troughs. The only issue I found is that in the first half of the route, we can see some underestimation of the peaks, and that's the cause of the lower average. And the first place actually goes to Amazfit GTS. There's only one obvious reading that's out of sync with the chest strap. Otherwise, the optical heart rate sensor is almost in line with the ECG HRM. Thank you all for watching. Let me know your thoughts in the comments below. If you found the heart rate test useful and insightful, then please click the red subscribe button below the video to ensure you don't miss any of our future content.